What's up guys, Jason here, and this is my best voiceover editing tutorial yet. I'm using Cakewalk to demonstrate my process of going from raw, unedited audio to a crisp and full voiceover with even volume levels. Cakewalk is 100% free, and all the plugins I'm using today are either free or I've provided a free alternative for, so rest assured this quality edit isn't at the expense of your wallet. You've actually been hearing the finished effect on this video's voiceover, so I'm gonna turn that off so you can compare it to sad, unedited audio. I'm gonna add the plugins back in real time, so as I talk about adding a plugin to the editing chain, it'll get dropped on this video's voiceover as well. Here's a blank Cakewalk project with nothing but the voiceover audio you're hearing right now. It was recorded on the Rode NT1 mic through the AI1 interface. Go ahead and watch the volume meter for a second to get a feel for the track volume and how dynamic my voice naturally is. More dynamic means a bigger difference between the loud and soft parts of a voice, and vice versa. Alright, let's pop the first plugin on here, Waves DeBreath. I paid $30 for this plugin, but the free alternative I'll recommend is Sonitus Gate, which comes with Cakewalk. Whichever you go with will be used in this chain as a breath reducer. I like to aggressively reduce breaths in my voiceovers since that's the sound I prefer, and doing that in Waves DeBreath is a two-step process based on two graphs. The top one, breath, represents how similar the audio is to the plugin's breath database, and below that, energy is basically how loud the audio is. To reduce breaths, you set the breath threshold above your speech but below breaths, and set the energy threshold below speech but above breaths. So when the breath likeliness is high enough and the energy level is low enough, the breath gets reduced. It sounds complicated, but you get the hang of it really fast, and it's only two controls at the end of the day. Now, Sonitus Gate works differently since it's a gate plugin that cuts out audio that falls below a certain volume. It's kind of like if DeBreath had no breath threshold and only an energy threshold. But in order to get close to having the same effect as DeBreath, I use a fast attack, no hold, and a medium-long release, and pull the threshold down until it's removing breaths but keeping speech. Gates are touchy, so trial and error is the key to getting Sonitus Gate to effectively reduce breaths. Next, I add TDR Nova, the trusty free EQ plugin. EQs let you precisely control the tone of your voice through the frequencies it's made up of. The frequencies go from low to high as you go from left to right on the EQ, and you drop down nodes that allow you to cut or boost at certain frequencies in the audio. Each node has the following controls: the frequency, which is where in the audio it works, the gain, which determines how much the node cuts or boosts at that frequency, and the filter shape and Q value, which change how the node blends into the line of surrounding adjustments. I use the nodes plus the low pass and high pass filters on the bottom left side of the plugin to boost pleasant sounding frequencies and cut unpleasant ones. Everything outside of around 90 Hz to 10 kHz gets rolled off, and I use resources like this vocal EQ cheat sheet to fill out the middle of the EQ with nodes. Doing that usually looks something like this, but it's important to not use cheat sheets as a crutch and EQ based on how things sound, not how they look, so I've really been trying to tweak heavily from my starting point depending on the project I'm working on. Real quick, I'm going to take 15 seconds here to tell you I've released shiny new Cakewalk voiceover presets. They're an excellent starting point for editing your voiceovers to a quality level, and they go very well with this video. The presets get you to a solid starting point, and the video explains basic settings so you can tweak to your own usage case. I'll talk more about them later in the video, so just keep these guys in mind. Next, I add another instance of TDR Nova, this time to function as what I call a smart high shelf. Like I covered in the previous step, one of the settings each node has in TDR Nova is the filter shape, and I only used bell filters in the previous instance of TDR Nova. A bell filter shape has the same slope on either side of the node, making it look like a bell. Here we're using only one node with a high shelf filter shape, which isn't symmetrical, and instead boosts to all frequencies higher than where the node is. Long story short, we're using that here to add crisp to our voiceover, starting around 5 kHz by 5 decibels. And I call this a smart high shelf because I set it up to dynamically reduce sibilance, the harsh s and sh sounds that you'll by nature pull out when you boost the highs. There will be more de-essing in the following steps, so if you're not familiar with dynamics processing in an EQ, then just skip putting that in. Next, I drop in VX64, which is built into Cakewalk for its de-esser function. De-essers do what they sound like they do and remove sibilance, and the VX64 de-esser has a very wide, smooth effect I just can't get away from. I have the frequency set to 6 kHz and the reduction set to at least 60%. VX64 is hidden in Cakewalk by default, so I'll drop instructions to enable it in the description below. Following that more subtle de-essing, I drop in Era 5 De-Esser Pro for some narrower, sharper de-essing. This plugin was part of the Era 5 bundle from Accusonus that they gave me access to a while back. Since then, the company got bought by Meta, like Facebook Meta, and their site's been down indefinitely. So my recommendation for a free alternative you can actually get is T-De-Esser. The controls and look are very similar to the Era De-Esser, so whichever you choose to go with, I'd stick to the default settings and push the threshold down until right before you give yourself a lisp. For me, that's again at least 60%. The second to last plugin is TDR Kotelnikov, a free compressor. Compressors are dynamics processors, and here we're using one to make our voiceover's overall volume more consistent. In previous videos, I've incorrectly said TDR Molotok, another compressor, is better for this usage case than Kotelnikov, but here I'll set the record straight. Molotok is good for adding saturation and harmonics, so character, to your audio, and Kotelnikov is good for clean, transparent compression. That's what we want here. The main settings are the threshold and ratio. The threshold is how loud the audio has to be to get compressed, and the ratio controls how much reduction happens. I go for a 4:1 ratio, sometimes 5:1, and push the threshold until the gain reduction meter shows 5 or so decibels of reduction. There's other settings like the attack and 2 release parameters, which control how fast the reduction comes in and out, but those have workable default settings. Similar to the EQ, I'm trying to make sure I don't just punch in the same numbers every single time, and instead hear what's going on, so definitely make sure to tweak your settings for your specific usage case. And last but not least, there's LoudMax, a free limiter plugin. I use this to control the loudness of the output audio. My goal generally is to get the peaks to -4 decibels for export. This is probably the easiest plugin to use in the entire chain. The top slider is the threshold, and I just watched the top meter for 10 seconds or so and set the slider to the highest point I saw in the 10 second time frame. This essentially locates the peaks of our audio. Then I set the second slider to adjust where those peaks are hidden. Again, I usually do -4 decibels. That's the last setting in LoudMax, which is the last plugin, so we're done. Our raw, unedited audio is now de-breathed, tonally adjusted to be crisp and full, and volume adjusted to be at a consistent volume that peaks at -4 decibels. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the edits to remind you of what we started with. As I talk with sad, unedited audio, let me further introduce you to my new Cakewalk Voiceover presets. I'm super excited to offer this pack of excellent starter settings for every plugin in this video, free and paid. These are the exact settings I use when I sit down to start a new voiceover edit. The preset files are incredibly easy to use, so from any open plugin in the video, you click VST3, then load preset, then select the appropriate preset file you downloaded. There's also a 14-page PDF guide that includes a basic overview of what every plugin in this video does, plus explanations of the most important settings. Also included are 3 unedited voiceover files for my own videos, so you can mess around with the presets on finished but unedited voiceover audio. I'm offering these guys for only $25, but they're on sale from the time this video is uploaded, so definitely head to the link in the description to grab them before the sale ends. I really think these presets will help a lot of you out, and I've priced them to be super affordable, so if you'd like a solid starting point for voiceover audio editing, consider giving up a few Starbucks coffees to jumpstart your work in audio. Besides that, thanks for watching. I hope this tutorial and potentially the presets help you with your creative pursuits, and if so, drop a like and a comment down below. Subscribe for more quality general tech and audio tech videos, and I'll see you later.